Welcome to this guide on how to use the fish consumption advisories prepared by the California Office of Environmental Health Hazard Assessment, or OEHHA. We provide guidance for people who catch and eat fish caught from California's lakes, reservoirs, rivers, bays, and coastline. Our guidelines help you enjoy the benefits of eating fish while minimizing your exposure to contaminants. Here's how to find and use these advisories. First, go to the OEHHA website and click on Fish in the navigation bar. Next, click on Fish Advisories. On this page, you can scroll down to see the alphabetical listing of water bodies that have advisories, or you can use the search functions or the advisory map on the page to find specific advisories. Once you've clicked on an advisory, scroll down to look at the advice for you and your family, based on gender and age. Then, find the type of fish that you plan to eat. In our advisories, we provide separate guidelines for people who are more sensitive to harmful contaminants found in fish. This group includes children 1 to 17 years of age who are especially sensitive to mercury. The sensitive group also includes women who are pregnant or may become pregnant, generally between 18 and 45 years of age, because unborn babies are also sensitive to mercury and other contaminants. Because mercury can stay in your body for a long time, women who are pregnant or may become pregnant, or are breastfeeding, should avoid eating fish with high levels of mercury. We provide a different set of advice for women 46 years and older and men 18 years and older. For example, women 18 to 45 years and children 1 to 17 years can eat as many as 7 servings per week of rainbow trout from Pyramid Lake, or they can eat 1 serving per week of catfish. They should not eat bullhead or black bass species, such as largemouth bass, from this lake because the contaminant levels are too high. Women 46 years and older and men 18 years and older can safely eat as many as 7 servings per week of rainbow trout, or 2 servings per week of catfish, or 1 serving per week of black bass species. They should also avoid eating bullhead from the lake. Rainbow trout are known to have higher levels of omega-3s, so this species is shown with a healthy heart icon for both population groups. Fish high in omega-3s are only labeled with a heart icon when OEHHA recommends they can be eaten at least once a week by a population group. It's important to note the "or" between the columns, because you should not combine servings. For example, if you eat a fish in the 1 serving per week group, you should wait until the next week to eat another fish from anywhere else, including fish purchased at a store or restaurant. That 1 serving of fish should be the only fish you eat that week. On the other hand, if you choose a fish from the 2 servings a week column, you can combine fish species from that column as long as your total does not exceed 2 servings. Scroll down further and you can see how big a serving size is. 1 serving is 8 ounces before cooking, or about the size and thickness of your hand for fish fillets. Keep that in mind if you tend to eat more than a single serving size during a meal. Always give children smaller portions. To further reduce your exposure to harmful chemicals in fish, here's some general advice for people who catch and eat sport fish. First, fish in different locations rather than in just one place. Some water bodies may have fish with higher levels of chemical contamination. Eat different types of fish, because some species of fish are more likely to accumulate certain contaminants than others. Try to eat fish species with lower levels of contaminants, such as rainbow trout and various small sunfish, including bluegill and red ear. Also, try to eat smaller fish within a species, since they may be younger and have had less time to accumulate chemicals and tend to be lower in contamination than larger fish. When preparing fish, remove the skin, trim visible fat, and cook in a way that allows the juice to drain away. Only eat the fillet portion of the fish, which contains the lowest levels of contamination. See the general tips section on our website under Fish Quick Links for additional advice on preparing and cooking fish and shellfish. If a water body where you want to fish doesn't have an advisory, follow our statewide advisory for eating fish from California's lakes and reservoirs without site-specific advice. We also have advisories for coastal fish and for fish that migrate. For more information, please see our other video on the benefits and risks of eating fish.